Today we're going to talk about 9.4, linear inequalities in two variables. So this is really putting together two ideas we've already reviewed. We've already gone over how to graph a linear equation. And we've also gone over on the last test, test one, module one, how to graph linear inequalities. But now we're in two variables. So I need you to think of it as a two-step problem. So I want you to think of it as, I know that there's three steps listed, but I want you to think of it as we're going to do our boundary first, and then we're going to decide which way to shade. Because I want you also to realize there is another way to do these problems, and some of you have learned how to graph them, putting them in y equals mx plus b form, and that's great. If you've done it, just be careful. It's super easy to do it incorrect. What I need you to know is that if we graph before, when we had, you know, y is less than negative 2, we graphed our boundary, we decided if it was an open or closed, and then we decided which way to shade. Same thing applies here. My boundary here is going to be a straight line, so I'm going to graph it the same way we went over before. So these problems will not tell you how to graph. I'm going to use my x and y intercepts, but you could use y equals mx plus b, and graph it using the slope-intercept format. You could plot any points that you want. So we're going to start there, and then we're going to decide which way to shade. So we're going to go to number one. So the first step I'm going to do is my boundary. And when I'm doing my boundary, I'm going to get rid of the inequality. I'm going to rewrite it with an equal sign because this is my boundary. But because this was a less than symbol, there is no equal to. We don't want to include it. So this is going to be a dotted or dashed line. Please write that down because it's easy to forget it. Before, I would put a parentheses or a bracket. For these problems, to color it in, we put a solid line if we want to include it, which means we have an equal to sign. If we do not have an equal to sign, this is a less than, so it's going to be a dotted. So I don't care how you draw this line, 4x plus 3y equals negative 12, but if you do not do a checkpoint on this or verify it and it's wrong, I want you to realize this is a 5 or 6 point problem on the test. So I'm going to find my x-intercept first, plug in y equals 0, and that means I'll get 4x equals negative 12, so I get x equals negative 3. My y-intercept, plug in x equals 0, I get 3y equals negative 12, y equals negative 4, so I get the point 0, negative 4. So I'm going to plot these two points. So I've got negative 3, 0, and I have 0, negative 4. And this is a dotted line, and there's a way to do that in my math lab. Now, I still really recommend doing a checkpoint because if you did something wrong, it's going to be completely wrong. So remember, a checkpoint doesn't matter if you get a decimal or not. So I put in here, I get 4 plus 3y equals negative 12. Subtract 4 from both sides. I get a negative 16. Y equals negative 16 thirds. That's 1, and that would be a negative 5 and 1 third. This is just a verify. So on your test, I want to stress, y'all can check so many of these problems. Do not turn the test in early if you haven't checked it. So one in there, which works. And so if you're one that gets flustered easy, please don't check them right away, but go back and check them before you press submit. So that's my step one, graphing, which we've been doing, and you will definitely be asked to do it on the test. My second part of this problem is to choose a test point, and I'm going to put it up here. So my test point is any point on this graph that is not on the boundary. Really what I want to do is I want to test which way I'm shading. That's my goal. Don't forget that. That's my goal, shading. And so if the point works when I plug it in, I have to color it in. If the point doesn't work, I don't want to color it in. So if you can, we want to pick the origin as my test point, because plugging in 0, 0 is the easiest point to plug in. And you're plugging it into the original problem. So 4 times 0 plus 3 times 0 is less than negative 12. So I get 0 is less than negative 12. And you need to say, is that a true answer or a false answer? 0 is not less than negative 12. if the statement was true, I would want to color this dot. This is a false statement, so I've got to color the other side. If I had a true statement, I would want to color that point in, which it is not, so I color the other side. You have two choices, color below or color above. You are coloring in what works. If you want to double check, you can pick a point over here and make sure it works as well. Again, at any stage that you need to pause, rewind, listen to it again, do it. So I've just scooted it over for example two. So we're going to start off with step one, which is the boundary, which says take out the inequality and replace it with an equal to. But please be careful. This has an equal to, so go ahead and write down before you go any further. Y'all are probably not going to mess up with a solid, but you're going to mess up with a dashed. So you can, again, graph this however you want. I'm going to use my x-intercepts and y-intercepts. So plug in 0 for y. I get 2x equals 4. X equals 2. So I have the point 2, 0. Y-intercept plugs in x equals 0. I get a negative 3y equals 4. So that one's not as pretty to graph. I get a 0, negative 4 thirds. So, again, this is where you might just have to play with it to get another point that works. I've told y'all to plug in 3 as a possibility. If I do plug into 3 into this, it's not going to give me a... If I plug in x equals 3, I'm going to just show you that I'll get 6 minus 3y equals 4. I still get a fraction. So another way, if this happens to happen, and this also leads you to the other format that I've said before, if you keep getting fractions and you're getting frustrated, then just take the equation, solve it, put it in slope-intercept form. So this would give me 2/3 x because I divide negative by negative, but be careful, you still have to divide the y-coordinate as well. This corresponds to that piece, but it shows you why you're getting threes in the denominator for those pieces. So you could actually use the slope to graph this one as well. So my slope is 2/3. So that means I'm going up 2 to the right 3. So up 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. This is a solid line. And remember that I got a negative 4/3, which is here for my y-intercept, which actually corresponds with this line. So that's my boundary. If you can graph with x and y-intercepts, awesome. If you always want to graph using slope-intercept form, for any problem except for the ones that say graph with your intercepts, you're good with that. So now I need to figure out my shading, which I'm going to use a test point. And if you can use the origin, we're going to use that. So I'm going to plug it into the original problem. So 2 times 0 minus 3 times 0 is greater than or equal to 4. So I get 0 is greater than or equal to 4. Is 0 greater than or equal to 4? Your answer there should be no. It's false. If it had been true, I would have shaded above because I wanted to color it in. Because this is my point right here. If I want to color it in and it works, I shade that side of the problem. But it's not true. So I want to shade the opposite side of that point. So that point goes away. It's not colored in. So I'm adding one extra problem on here because I see people get caught up on this one. So I want to just give you an example so that if this happens, you know what to do. So notice that this is a problem where y is greater than negative 3x. There's no constant term. So this one is going to have, for my graphing, it's going to be y equals a negative 3x. So my x-intercept, when I plug in 0, I'm going to get 0 equals negative 3x, so x equals 0. So my x-intercept and my y-intercept are 0. And I forgot to do this, but this would be a dotted line. So this is a case where the x and y-intercepts are the same, so I just got to plug in another x value. So x equals 1, this would give me y equals negative 3. I get 1, negative 3. X equals 2, I get y equals negative 6. So I have the point 1, negative 3. which is here. I have the 0.2, negative 6, and be careful. It's dashed, dotted. But this is why I wanted to do this one. The test point we normally pick is the origin, which is my green dot. I can't use it. It's on the line. So I have to pick something else. So I want y'all to realize we use 0, 0 just because it's an easy point. I can pick any point that is not on there. So when picking the 0.2, 0, I'm going to plug it in to my original inequality. I get 0 is greater than negative 6. Is 0 greater than negative 6? My answer should be yes. That's a true statement. So because it's true, and this is the point that I just plugged in, I have to color that in. So I color that side. Please, please make sure you double check what you're doing on these. Double check your graph, double check your dotted versus solid, double check which side you shade. There's an extra video of examples on Canvas for this as well.